This next bout is for the heavyweight championship of the world. Making his way to the ring, the challenger, a former professional football player with the Los Angeles Rams.
It ain't the challenger!
He's weighing in at 375 pounds. He is Leon, the baby bull, White. Already in the ring, the heavyweight champion of the world is from Borger, Texas. Weighing in at 303 pounds, Stan the Lariat Hansen. Your referee is Marty Miller. Now down to ringside, your Lord James Blues and Vern Gagne.
Okay, well, you see a couple of big men in here just thinking about the earthquake, and this man here, big Leon Baby Bull White, he weighs heavier than the earthquake, and look at the condition. He's tough and he's rugged. This man, Bell High School, Los Angeles, Big 8, All-American, and he was a first draft choice for the Los Angeles Rams. He presses, sports fans, five, you weightlifters, are you ready? 550, warm-up, 550. Stan the Lariat Hansen, Stan the man, world champ. 303 pounds, he'll wrestle you, he'll kick you, he'll fight you, he'll bulldoze you, he'll do anything he can as quick as he can. Remember, he's not going to play around with you. If he sees an opening to finish you off, he's not going to try and be a little cocky and kind of show his body around there. He's going to whap you and finish it. That's Stan the Lariat Hansen.
White is a big, big, powerful man at 375 pounds. And Lord, with that 575, he does repetitions with that. So you know that he's got to have some power there. Out of Colorado, Boulder.
Clemson side headlock.
He's gaining more confidence all the time in his wrestling ability. He's not been wrestling that long, but when you give him another one or two more years, and this man may be a world champion himself. In fact, he may win it right here tonight. Who knows? He's explosive.
Yes, I've heard you say that before, Vern, about another year or two, and sometimes all of a sudden a guy will suddenly get lucky and become the world champion. Does happen.
That's right. Oh.
Hanging on with the power.
Sitting next to us, we have the hostess here at the showboat, the glamorous and beautiful Judy Moore.
Hello, Judy. Tally-ho.
One of our great wrestling fans. Would you say hello to the fans, Judy?
Hello, wrestling fans.
Hello. Beautiful.
Well, it's a beautiful city, a beautiful town, a beautiful arena, and a great club, Showboat. Okay.
Big Showboat being built in Atlantic City, Lord. You love to see that one.
Look at this, a tackle. Oh! Look at this big man running. Oh, and they
look at the agility of him.
All right, and look at the fans. They love it. Everybody giving the thumbs up sign. Oh, big Leon White. All the football fans and wrestling fans will know who he is. He is. You know who the world champion is. We know that.
Feel the back on him. He's just really a big, huge, huge, powerful man. I imagine the Rams wish they still had him.
Nice wide step. Referee, Marty Miller.
Excuse me, Ed Strangler Lewis with that headlock. That was his big famous hold many, many years ago, Lord. And I don't know if Ed Strangler can put it in any harder than this young man is doing.
Oh,
move.
Yeah, there's a two count on the champ, and that's how close it can be. 1/20th of a minute. Seems like a 1, 2, 3, but that's not the count. You must count 1 and 2 and 3. Seems like a short time, but it is quite a long time to hold a man down. These big men, you have to wear them down to hold them down. You can't just get a quick fall on these giants.
Look at Hansen. Got that cross face across the face of White. But White powers his way back.
Now he holds on to big forearms, bunching up on him. Look at the size of those arms. Those arms are the size of the average beautiful young lady's waist. And she's now you're saying hello to the wrestling fans.
About 21 inches around the waist, isn't it?
Well, sports fans, I want to tell you something. If you didn't make that mark on the calendar, April the 20th, St. Paul, Minneapolis, St. Paul, the Metrodome, the Twin Cities, the biggest wrestling rock, 86, is the first time there's ever been professional wrestling at the Metrodome. It's the biggest attraction, sports attraction, in that area that's ever been. Believe me, I tell you no lie.
WrestleRock. Oh, you missed it. That WrestleRock, that may break all indoor records ever in wrestling history, period, throughout the world. Metrodome, 86.
Records are made to be broken, and I'd like to see it.
Judy Moore is flying in with a group from Las Vegas.
And don't forget Rapid City, Gillette, Wyoming, and Denver, Colorado. For the wrestling fans in Denver, they're fantastic.
Paul Caruso out of Southern California is bringing a group, a whole airplane load for that Metrodome shot on the 20th out of Hollywood and Beverly Hills.
That's great. It's
going to be interesting to see who he brings. I think your friend Don Rickles already got a seat on that plane.
Now you can see the size of the neck. He has a short neck, what the wrestlers call a short neck. It'll be very difficult to get a headlock on big Leon Baby Bull White. So he's holding on to the neck of the lariat right now. There he is. There's a close-up. You can see him. A bull neck. It's all wrestlers call a bull neck. The worst thing you do would be to try and work on a man like that on his neck. Go for his legs or a weak part of his body if you can find one.
One thing about Hansen, he's going to have a longer face than he had before with the pressure that White has put on him.
Look at him pushing. Boy, pushing and shoving. That's what the world is today. Push and shove. And wrestling it into the rope. Look how he moved. And he got kicked in the solar plexus.
Oh!
You can hear that one across the boulevard. He kicks Hansen, and Hansen goes down. Big Leon White now ready, moving in. Hansen gets grabbed once again. Hooks that head, the mark of a good wrestler. Follow through, grab the same hold if it's working.
He's grinding him down, Lord. He's got a good plan. If he can stick to it.
Keep the pressure on. Try and get that carotid artery if you can. Pop that blood supply to the head, and you have him half asleep.
I wonder how wrestlers get cauliflower ears.
Okay, that's how you get cauliflower ears. Head scissors and headlock. Oh. He took that like getting hit with about 15 tackles. Now Hansen arm drags this man down, takes the arm, throws both knees in, grabs the Japanese arm bar on the mat, grabs the fingers, wrist, double wrist lock, and arm. And Leon is in a little trouble right now. Not to be pinned, but a lot of pain.
His hand is turning white already. I guess the name like White, maybe it'll turn white.
It did look that way, and it happens. Sometimes you lose all circulation in the arm. Anyway, you're watching professional wrestling on the tombs of Benny Hassan in Egypt. You can see Cobb, the same holes that you're looking at right now in 1986, right here in Las Vegas, Nevada, at the Showboat. Go to Egypt if you can afford it. Go in the tombs and see these very same holes. Wrestling's been going on for 3,000 years.
You see Hansen sneak and grab those two fingers or one finger and twist it. That got to the Baby Bull.
Yes,
it was illegal, but he did it. There he goes again.
Right, he's doing it again. And again, a difficult job, as I've said before, weeks before, for the referee to be running around, looking for the pin, and also looking for an illegal move by the other man. So then people will say to you, why not have two referees? Why not have 10 referees? but you can't do that. This is a sport that calls for one referee unless sanctioned by the Alliance for Two. And the NFL, we read about it in the newspapers yesterday, the day before. They're going to have replays. Will it happen in wrestling? I don't know. You never know. The more things change, the more they remain the same. Oh!
He's thumping him away now. White's got to get off those ropes, Lord. He's got to get off those ropes. He's got to move that hand around.
Well,
getting used to pain is another thing in wrestling that you're really not used to. I mean, you get it in football, but not where they grind away on you for a long period of time, as they do in professional wrestling.
Right. Well, there's no timeouts. You don't get a chance to sit on the sideline and think about it. You're on, but it's a tough sport too, football. I take my hat off to rugby players, football players, and all professional athletes. Handful of tights, the referee's warning him. If I catch you doing it, if you don't see it now, the referee cannot call it.
If he got two, supposed to have two fingers, the referee's not breaking it.
Now, if someone can get the message to Big Leon Baby Bowl White to try and get up and grab the headlock again, he might be in a little better position.
Well, it's pretty hard with that hand, the way he's working on it, to even squeeze it. What happened to Hansen? I think he lost.
He disappeared.
Two, three, four.
He slipped out of the ring on the floor, got right back. He takes it. He smashes it on the side of the ring, on the step. On those 4x4s. Takes the arm. And Hansen hits the steel post. Big punch, you can feel it right at ringside. Another one, they're fighting outside the ring. The count is continuing. The referees get up to 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. They're fighting outside the ring. I can't hear the count. The right referee's giving them the opportunity to continue.
It's a world's title match.
In the ring.
Oh.
And White comes back with a tremendous judo chop. Takes Hansen, throws it in the ring. And this man's got a lot of guts. Big Baby Bowl Leon White.
He's a little slow getting in there. He's going to get in. Got those
great bars.
Look at this.
Hansen's in. Gives him the big elbow. Shaking his hand. Trying to return the blood circulation. The big tackle. Throws one. Watch him, football style. Here he goes now. Launches himself, knocks him down, hurts himself a little, but he's got Hansen, the world champ. He's going for the title. He's going, he's covering his man. This could be it, folks. Oh, it was only a two count.
Close to a three count, Lord.
Oh, my God. We could have seen the title change hands in Las Vegas, and why not? The fans say, let's do it. The big headbutt. He takes his man now, slams him in the far corner, charges, hits him with a knee, and Hansen's in a lot of trouble. The champion is in trouble. Does it count? One, two, and oh, I nearly said it. But body's outside the ring, as you can see. Foot on the ropes. Why not, Vern? If you're in trouble, stick your foot out. I did it a lot of times.
He saved himself right there. But
oh.
Geez, where, oh, look at
oh. And the big lariat covers, pushes him down. That's all over. The champion barely made it, but he did.
Jack Knight. Lord White gave him all he wanted here tonight. He got a quick 1, 2, 3 on him. White hit that turnbuckle hard and then caught a 4 on the cross the throat. It was just down long enough for that 3 count. He kicked him off, threw him out of the ring, but it was too late.
I had him, if it was scoring on points for it, I would have had him ahead, Mike.
Yes, he certainly would, man.
But that
would.
The winner is the world champion, and still, here he goes. Watch this. Slips away. And watch the punch now. The lariat, smash. Double leg Nelson. Oh. Holding him down. There's the slow-mo. And there's two big men.
The 1, 2, 3, and that was it. White has had a great, great future in professional wrestling.
Okay, sports fans, we'll be back. Don't go away. Wrestling, action, everything happening at the Showboat in Vegas.